morning to you all. To thank my colleagues for the opportunity of being here. And as this is a symposium about formal methods, I thought it would be interesting to bring you a human imaginal experience in which we reduced formal, semi-formal, and informal methods. So,
the goal was to finish the set.
Departments of Biology and Ceramic and Glass Engineering were established the heights and the areas of implementation. Simple rules were informally defined in dialogue to create consensus with the architects. Basically, it consisted in creating, at the ground floor level, a covered external circulation link between two buildings, and the option of the same material in the facades, briquette sites, was an architect's choice. So this is one of those buildings with the passage in the ground and the brick. The library project near the main square. There was not a big degree of conceptual freedom given to the architects. This was particularly notorious in the case of overseeing a project for the library, who was authorized to change the dimensions and the location of the building to open a lane from the campus to the other way. So you change the position in order to allow this direct relation between the interior of the campus and the bay with this magnificent views. In the peripheral areas of the campus, the problems were different. In the zone situated between the North Departmental Complex and the Aveiro Bay, SETA did not initially predict constructions attending to its environmental quality, which was this area over here. Confronted with the necessity of construction in this area, and only at that moment and not before, the process was managed informally. Nuno Portas made a simple sketch of the implantation of the buildings with the idea of the least possible landscape obstruction. There were also established the same rules concerning heights of the buildings and facade materials used in the campus, also in an informal way. The zone of the residences has been kept in the same area as predicted in the original plan, which was this area over here. By the time the revision of the plan was elaborated, there was only financing for the construction of 500 rooms. For that reason, the students' residences were the only buildings defined rigorously in the new plan. The process has passed by the execution of a comparative typological study, non-binding, that assured the viability of the proposal contained in the plan. This was typological studies. The sports zone was another area where it was conferred the maintenance of the original intended function of the first plan. The great dimension of the equipment, namely the athletic track and the football field, implied the achievement of the Dillon study. So it was in this area over here. The zone of the departmental expansion south, which from now on we refer as ZES, was designed for the new departments of teaching and investigation. In this area, it was rehearsed the process that came to be known as the urban project in the actual definition that Nuno Portas gives to it. The heterogeneous process of urbanistic management we just saw, brought to Nuno Portas the conviction that it was necessary to transform the traditional static plans into an open process where provisions can be changed according to circumstances. In this area, existed certainty about the function of the buildings, but great uncertainty on the specific programs of the departments, and also on the construction times, dependent on community funding. In 1998, Nuno Portas defended that, to deal with the problems related with uncertainty and time, the urban project must, and I'm quoting, to store degrees of freedom between its parts without losing with it elements of continuity and readability, end of quotation. The support ensuring the permanence of these elements are the collective public spaces as the streets, squares, and gardens. Quoting again Nuno Portas, in other words, are the spaces that give continuity to the city, serving and connecting buildings. As they are collective, these spaces live on. End of quotation. For this reason, he started using ground projects. Quoting again, this type of intervention has as basis an independence between the supporting serves and the edification that will be served, and which prediction may inclusively be changed. End of quotation. So the process followed to organize this area was sequential. First, it began with the introduction of a grid, established and partially modulated from the pre-existing alignments. This grid model has been set from the dimension of the class spaces most commonly used at Aveiro University, one classroom for 32 students. Over the grid, And I'm very sorry about the colors, because the central plane should be green and it's gray over here. Over the grid, taking advantage of the displacement of the library, we introduced the central lane and the gallery open to the other way. Though it's very so difficult to see it here in these conditions, but permanently the central lane were deployed in several spaces in for the isolation of the building. So this should be green because this, the spaces between the buildings are external and green. So, the departments were placed in the remaining space. And finally, it was introduced the possibility of construction or union of the buildings. We can now state that the buildings were defined from the remaining space of the overlap of the various collective urban entities, the central lane, the gallery, and the external spaces. The ground project, which is in fact the layout of the collective public spaces, has been allowing the reporters on the coast of Rio Grande to defend the possibility of drawing the cities without having to draw the buildings. The grand project, voting in reporters again, can be elaborated as a project of execution for the public or collective space and as a set of rules. In the definition of the mentioned set of rules, in other words, the terms of reference and discipline construction, displaces the problem of how to replace what you will publish again, the determinism of the rules about what can be done by other kind of dispositions on how to make it and with which criteria decisions must be taken. The objective has passed consequently by the refusal of the imposition of the form of the buildings to focus on ensuring what was considered most important, which was the framework of the buildings as a whole, ensuring the overall consistency of this area and the desired unity image of the campus without unnecessary conditioning the architects. There are some facts to consider about the plan for this area. First of all, the ZES area was designated to the construction of the buildings of the departments, but it was ignored what would be the time phasing of the constructions. Second one, knowing which department existed on the university, there were doubts about the new areas of study that might be implemented in the future, the opportunity, as well as the kind of spaces these less buildings would need, the uncertainty. Further, on the other hand, CEFA intended to make profitable the use of the new facilities once the departmental and interdisciplinary character of the university led to a practice based on the mobility of the school community, being ordinary teachers and students to attend classes in distinctive buildings of those where they were enrolled. Fourth, it was therefore necessary to ensure flexibility in the general regulation of the construction of buildings, maintaining the idea that it was intended a unitary image for the entire campus. With these objectives, some measures were adopted. First, it was decided that the buildings would have three floors height. Second one, in order to enable the construction of buildings with different areas, were planned longer units on the eastern side, this side over here, and smaller in the west side. These last ones, in the shape of U, assured the possibility of building departments of large dimension, or yet a union of two of them. Fourth, it was predicted the interpolation of constructions in order to ensure the possibility of expanding departments to the adjacent parcel if necessary. So they start building this one and this one and this one in order to have the possibility of connecting to the other parcel if with the time the university was necessary to expand the departments. Fifth, to ensure the flexibility in each parcel, it was stipulated an area of desirable deployment with 14 meters wide and a max. Sixth, it was also defined a commonplace construction range situated along the gallery of optional character and flexible dimension, designated to classrooms that could be attended by students from various departments. On the other hand, it was elaborated an occupation regulation of the departmental units with three groups of purely indicative typological studies. The first one, this one, the simulation of the association of the spaces of the departments was studied in function of the two wide span of 14 and 20 meters, and it aimed to demonstrate several possibilities of internal organization of the buildings. The second study, which this is partially the second study, to the commonplace track were studied eight kinds of classrooms with capacities that varied between 32 and 196 students. It was the dimension of the smallest classroom, the one of 32 students, this one, that served as basis to the establishment of the model of the grid of sets. The first study, this one, the indicative elements for the functional occupation of the departments was a study that aimed to present several hypotheses of desirable location of the functional cores of the departments studied according to the optimization of displacement inside the buildings. They were also informally established some rules with the architects. Finished the revision of the plan, SEFA met with the architects already contracted and, in dialogue, sought the establishment of several consensus related with the construction of the buildings. Of this meeting has resulted the extension to all campus of the regulation, never written, to use the brick on the facades. Quoting the reportage again, in the urban project, the priority is given to the assembly of feasibility conditions to the church of partners or necessary consensus, being the location and the land in view only one of the data to have into account and to compare in time of decision with other possible alternatives possible, although different from those set. End of quotation. The method cannot be therefore the one of the traditional plan fixed in the design, and will now be a dynamic process that unfolds over time. In 1998, you referred that the method to employ will be then, quoting again, interactive, introducing new information from the part to the whole during that term, testing the robustness of the assumptions and admitting its rearrange. End of quotation. So, in order to a urban project to be open to opportunities without the need for the revision of the plan, it needs the establishment of the support structure and the ensures the immutability of the collective public spaces. This structure, defined by the grant project, implies, quoting again to the reporters in 1998, the execution project for the public space and a set of rules. End of quotation. This wasn't the process followed in Aveiro. What was done in Aveiro was the use of an urban management process diversified and heterogeneous, in which models were chosen in function of the needs and the data available in each moment. Even in Z, the most elaborated area of the plan, the collective areas were defined rigorously, definition which was only held later with the Alcides Rodrigues plan of streets and exterior arrangements of the campus. So then, how was it possible with a plan with these characteristics to obtain the unitary result that the campus displays these days? So this is the drawing, the revision of the master plan in 1998. This is the plan of streets and exterior arrangements made by Alcides Rodrigues in 1989, 1 year after. This is the campus in 2006, and as you can see, there's an enormous resemblance between the drawing of the campus and the street data, which means that the plan was successful and it was carried out, even if it was, even though it was a camp with several informal methods of urban management. What enabled this result was the capacity of urban management of the plan that knew how to take advantage based on the defense of the conductive idea of the different process used through variable regulation to guide in each moment the unitary construction of the campus. Our studies have shown that the managers uncomprehensively defended the plan whenever architects questioned its fundamental principles. The revision of the master plan of the Aveiro University is not a urban project in the definition today defended by the reporters. But it is perhaps the experience that allowed to define the underlying theory. The urban project, in that definition, is an open process of urban management based in three essential points. The elaboration of the ground project, the use of variable regulation, and the definition of flexible terms of reference. This methodological process to deal with the variables cannot dispense the implementation of management based on the clear definition of the principle, the matrix idea, that generates the conducting wire that must guide all planning operations. In this case, the will to obtain a unitary image of the campus. Consequently, and this aspect is particularly important, it cannot equally dispense of the uncompromising defense of that conducting wire. This is what happened in the Santiago campus. Indeed, only the capacity, based on the circle of convictions, to follow the conducting wire outlined in the urban project can, with base in the use of the three essential points previously mentioned, lead to the possibility of the defense of its management. Thank you very much.